Hey guys, I'll explain a bit about the engine cooling system and whether it is normal for coolant levels to decrease over time. Here on this Honda cooling system, we have the radiator with its pressurized cap that leads to a reserve or overflow tank. While the radiator tank is pressurized, this coolant reserve tank isn't really pressurized. The cap that goes on it, it's not really a tight seal. This also has holes in it on both ends, so coolant can escape through this. It can evaporate. So over time, it is normal for the coolant levels to drop. Let's say it drops from the maximum to the minimum within a week or two, then you might have a problem. I did have that happen to me once where the coolant was dropping very rapidly, and it turned out I had a crack in the plastic cap. So that allowed more coolant to evaporate quickly. Coolant expands when hot. That is why you check your levels when your vehicle is cold. Never fill above the max level. The extra space you have here is for coolant expansion. I have seen people who filled coolant to the top of this bottle right here. Their cars ran okay because this here is designed to be the weakest part of the cooling system. As I said earlier, this overflow tank isn't pressurized. The cap is flimsy and you have holes where excess coolant can actually spill out. However, with excess pressure buildup, if you have too much coolant, it can lead to blown hoses or cracking in these plastic overflow tanks, more so on old cars. So be mindful not to cross the max level. Here we have a second gen Toyota Fortuner. There is no cap on the radiator, but we have a cap on this plastic tank. Now we wouldn't call this an overflow or reserve tank. Technically we call it an expansion tank because this is pressurized along with the radiator. However, it functions the same. You're not supposed to cross the max level. If you do cross the max level, here you can see we have this exit port, which is covered, but this is designed to be the weakest part of the system. So if we exceed the rated pressure mentioned on the radiator cap, it will open up to relieve this pressure and excess coolant can flow out. Better for the coolant to flow out from here than damaging some hose or some seal. With this type of design, coolant loss will be more minimal than the previous design where you had the unpressurized overflow tank. In conclusion, it is normal for coolant levels to drop over time. To be on the safe side, check it every 3 to 4 weeks. Always top up your coolant with the same brand. Never mix different types of coolants. You can easily get pre-mixed coolant from your manufacturer. The coolant for your engine is a maintenance item. Do check your owner's manual. It will mention the time or distance it has to be replaced. I do have a detailed video on how to replace your coolant. I do mention a few things you must do and must be careful of. For example, it's very important to burp your system, meaning getting all the air out of your cooling system. If you don't, that could cause your engine to heat up. Some engines, which include most Honda engines, do have an engine drain block. In this engine, it's located on the back. This allows you to drain more of the old coolant out. I hope you found this video informative. Please consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.